And also you see here, we have welcomed the Mal Madrasa, which is a Quran Madrasa of our masjid. We established this one in 1997, Mal Madrasa. Over 100 students, currently they are both males and females, boys and girls, the minors basically. They attend the regular Quran classes, which is the foundation for any Muslim. It starts with the Quran classes, and then you go above and, you know, you learn about the tafsir and the other things. And the beauty of it in this madrasa is everything is given free of charge, including the kitabs, uniforms, stationaries. So we don't charge anything. You know, this area, majority of them are either middle or lower middle class. So the board decided that we will do support much as possible for them to complete their education. As I mentioned, whoever studied here, some of the students have become Maulavis and Hafiz. And Alhamdulillah, we hope through this madrasa there will be more Hafiz and Maulavis. And also, when you talk about Vyakanta Masjid, you have a dargah here. Most of you all know, called St. Hussein Bibi Shrine Dargah. It is located actually in the vicinity, you can see, opposite the masjid. This space has been frequently visited by many devotees for a long period of time. I think it's almost 80-90 years. There's an annual flag hoisting being held on the first day of Rabiul Akhir, and the Qutb Mawlud is recited for 11 days. And during the third month, Rabiul Awal, the Rasul Mawlud is recited in the night, for 12 nights. Now I just touched about the history. When we complete 225 years in this calendar and 232 Hijri years, what is the way forward? What are we planning to do? Alhamdulillah, we have the masjid building. Now we have to make use of it. So what we want to do is, while playing a key role within the Muslim community in Slave Island, also we, the Trustee Board, is determined to make this masjid a center place for Sri Lankan Malays for their spiritual development. So how are we going to achieve this? So as you know, we said in our communication that we are going to launch a website today. So the key purpose of launching this website is also to achieve that goal. You know, we have Jumma sermons here, and even in Sri Lanka, if you take 95% of the sermons are done in Tamil. There are Malays who don't understand Tamil. Then there are non-Malays also. Even our more brothers, they don't, who have studied in Tamil or in English, they find it difficult to understand those high words. If you use the high words in Tamil, they don't understand. So what we want to do is, even once a month, a Jumma sermon is conducted by our Chief Khatib, Maulavi Muzli Amir. But unfortunately, he cannot conduct the whole thing in Malay, because it is not fair by, because more than 45% of the crowd who come here, the office crowd and other non-Malays, they won't understand. Therefore, what he has to do is, he is compelled to summarize. At the end of the Jumma, his Tamil sermon, he is compelled to summarize within 3 or 4 minutes. So we find this is not enough. And when it comes to Malay lectures, Islamic lectures, Sri Lanka Broadcasting Corporation, they have given us 2 slots, I think, for a week. So that is also, sometimes you find it doesn't go, because we don't have a sponsor for this program. So sometimes if they say 10 o'clock, it can be 10:20 and it goes here and there. So what we thought was, in this masjid, we will organize a series of Islamic lectures. It will be monthly lectures, which will be conducted in Malay. Currently, Akbar Masjid, Najmiatul Ulama, and the Federation together, they are conducting monthly lectures in Tamil. And yesterday, there was the second lecture, which was conducted by Sheikh Arkab Noor Amit. Actually, he spoke in Tamil, not in Malay. He conducted in Malay, in Tamil. So there are plenty of lectures going in Tamil. So we want to have a lecture which is purely done in Sri Lanka, Malay language. We have, we have a large building, we have the infrastructure. What we can do, we can attract both gents as well as ladies. We have separate arrangements, so alhamdulillah, we can make arrangements. So Malays from all parts of the island, particularly in Kalamu district, they can come and get the benefit. It will be conducted, inshallah, in the morning at about 10:30 or so. It will go till Luhar, and they can pray Luhar and can go back after the program. And the Malays in other part of the island, even if they are in abroad, now we have this website. What we can do is we can broadcast live through our ayakandamasjid.com website, and also subsequently we can upload that bayan, so we can preserve. Yeah, there were many bayans done even in SLBC. We wanted the copies. Alhamdulillah, we got few of the MP3 copies, and they are uploaded in the website, so it will be made available from today onwards for you all. You can access the site, but unfortunately most of the bayans were erased, so they also didn't store, so we had only few. So what we will do is, inshallah, every bayan will be uploaded, inshallah, in the web. And also, the SLBC in future, whatever programs, SLBC programs conducted by Maulana Muzi Amir, we have Aslam Maulavi and Maulavi Mahir Ramdin, they conduct these programs. What we will do is, inshallah, each and every program from today onwards, whatever program broadcast on SLBC will be uploaded to the web. So that inshallah, from anywhere in the world, you will have the access and you can listen and get the benefit out of it. So finally, the Tasheed of the Masjid, while thanking you for your presence here, and wish you to invite you to make use of this Masjid and its website in order to become a true winner of both in this world and hereafter. Jazakallah, wa salam, subhanakallah, wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta.